It was my first command. I had been appointed only a fortnight before. I was a stranger to the ship, and if all the truth must be told, I was somewhat of a stranger to myself.
I can't. It's got...
I do not understand.
They were not angry. I think it was pleasant for them.
But what is to be gained? It is not a dance. It gathers no food. It does not serve Val.
Anything I say get through to you?
I don't remember. I don't remember anything about last night.
You have these blackouts often?
I live with them.
Smile, kid. What?
A 12 to hit is just the same as any other number above it. Only better. Don't let anybody tell you different.
Hi, how are you? Yes, Gloria!
Risking a wonderful girl like Jenny because of some stupid mistake.
That stupid mistake, Dad, happens to be a flesh and blood little baby boy.
Doug, let the girl have the baby. Use your head. You and Jenny are just kids. Marriage is tough enough without something like this hanging around your necks.
Dad, I'm a father. Now, that may not have meant very much to you, but I am not going to slough my responsibility by writing a lousy check every month. You see, Dad, you don't just buy the diapers. You have to change them, too.
It's not just a question of whether or not to use violence. There simply is no other way, Inspector. You, of all people, should understand that.
Are you going to make believe that nobody knows what I'm talking about?
Why don't you tell us what you're talking about, Sean?
I know what he's counting on. My sister's a sickie. What's anybody going to want to do to her? Not guilty by reason of, you know. And so they put her in a state hospital for not too long, which is better than he gets life in state prison. Right, Dr. C? Well, forget it, man, because I'm not going to let you do it to her. I don't want any more of your institute commissions. I don't know why the hell I ever did this one.
I'm Air Force! I'm not some wild-eyed kook looking to get on a 6 o'clock news. You understand? You don't have to try to convince me. Just give me an order, something on paper, something I can show my men.
You're speaking hypothetically.
No, you weren't! You want me to shut up? Give me an order!
No, that's not it at all.
I want an order now!
Sit down.
funny. I always knew that our love affair was three-cornered. Me and Susie and money. She wanted to be rich. She thought money could buy all the answers. All of them.
Yeah, I know.
Declare your guts, is that it, Johnny? Declare your guts!
God, get away! Oh, God!
Johnny?
Get out of here!
You don't need me? You don't need Lisa, right?
Do it myself.
You don't need Patrick?
Do it myself.
You don't need anybody, right?
Get away!
Is that it? Get away! Okay. All right, then go ahead. Do it, Gutless.
Get up!
Declare your guts.
That subpoena wasn't a half bad magic wand, but it didn't help us find the nurse that goes with that log. Seems she moved out of San Francisco and didn't leave a forwarding address. Neighbor said she came down of Los Angeles.
Here's an entry just 3.5 hours following the birth.
You've been stringing me along for the last 3 days. Is that what you've been doing? Just stringing me along so I'd help you get your dog back?
Funny, I've been wondering the same thing about you. I've been asking myself, what's he think he's gonna get from me?
And what's the answer?
Somebody to hold your hand, somebody to give you the guts you don't have by yourself. A ride out!
You, go get your wedding dress on.
Beautiful!
You're late.
Excuse me. You know, I'm coming down here to watch your sweat. It's not the high point of my day.
Go ahead.
I got coffee and a Danish. You want to share?
Have I ever?
No, but I keep hoping.
So which side of the bed do you want? The cold and lumpy side?
Asking me or telling me?
I'm asking you a favor.
What's a favor?
Leave your car door open for the next cold, tired kid so she can find a place to sleep without committing a felony.
You've got to go back to Boston. There's a kind of plague in this town. People are dying. Don't you understand what's happening?
Do you?
Yes, I do. It's in the Marston house. It's got to be rooted out. It's got to be destroyed.
A minute, I'd like
what are you
to
gonna talk. Do something for me? You gonna help me? You don't listen to me because you don't give a damn.
Al,
you back off. You stay away from me. One of you, you back off. You stay away. I know what you do to me. You're messing with my head.
No, wait a minute.
You don't want to help me. I know what you do. Sit around you throw around your judgments. You don't want to help me. You don't want to help me get out of here. You don't want to help me get better.
I want to help you to get out of here.
I don't know.
Anything was possible. And I was going to be the new Hemingway. I was going to visit the most beautiful places on earth, love the most beautiful women, and be an honest-to-God legend. I wonder what happened.
You've done okay.
Yeah, I suppose. Okay is not what I set out to do.
Not just because it's home sweet home, but because it's a part of the past, it's a way into the future that I want to be a part of. And if we're more worried about oil, cows, real estate than we are about people, then I don't think that the yellow rose is worth having in the first place.
Look, there's a couple of robes up there in the bedroom. I'll show you where they are.
No. I'd rather go change the lock.
Oh, I understand.
Do you take care of this for me?
Hey, the light switch is on the right.
Thank you.
I'm going to cash this check. Then we're going to go buy you one of those flimsy slit-up assigned type packages. And then one by one, I'm going to take them all off.
Stay away from my family.
I've done things in my life that I'm not proud of, Emily. Right now, I must tell you, it surprises even me. I'm ready to do something decent.
This man right here saved my life once on a mission.
In Vietnam?
I can't say any more about it than that. It's still classified.
I don't believe you.
Lady, I was a platoon leader. You look up my record at Fort Ord. At Fort Campbell, I was Army Airborne. You know something? I don't care if she believes me or not.
Task force.
Because one of the highest ranking female homicide detectives we've got on the Women's Committee is our request to you.
You know what they're going to say about this, about us, again.
Kelly.
My friend.
Not anymore, I'm not.
How's Judge, what's his name?
How's your wife?
God, you're tough. Why are you so tough, huh? Come on. It's my birthday today. I'm pushing 50. Today.
Mustn't keep Captain Lewis waiting.
You're not jealous, are you?
No. Just a little concerned.
You weren't concerned back in Kansas.
You weren't Mrs. Stiles, then.
Psychological impact that a guilt-ridden parent can have on a child. You owe it to your daughter to sign that statement. If you care about her, you do as I say.
At yourself. They call you the king of crime where you're about to go down.
Let me tell you something, wise guy. I could have you taken out where you stand right now. And any one of the babysitters, the special prosecutor, is watching me around the clock.
She's all I've got.
No, she isn't.
hoping with a bit of luck that I would have straightened everything out by the time she took control.
And the statue head was what? An opportunity too tempting?
That was an accident! I tripped over my golf club! And I didn't kill her either! You hear me? You're not gonna pin that on me. And you never will.
Not bad, huh? Makes you want to see the whole picture.
Well, I didn't have time to organize a screening for you, but I wanted at least to show you how in the film the point of view changes. It's a masterpiece.
Drifting, searching, shifting from town to town. Every time I slip and slide a little further down. I can't blame you if you won't take me back. After everything I put you through, but honey, you're my last hope, and who else can I turn to?
If you can do one thing in your lifetime that is remembered, that gives such joy to audiences, count yourself lucky.